I never thought I'd see this happen. Welcome to the Real Food Roundup, where I share with you the top real food recipes, tips, and articles. And this week, we have some exciting news coming from none other than McDonald's. And that's not a sentence that I say very much, exciting news coming out of McDonald's. Basically, what's going on is they have announced that they are going to be eliminating the use of human antibiotics in the chickens that they purchase. So this is kind of a big deal. Now, the reasoning for this is because there is a huge concern right now with antibiotic resistant bacteria. So if you're not up on that whole situation, let me give you the short version. Basically, when we use antibiotics a lot and we overuse them and use them inappropriately, it can cause these antibiotic resistant bacteria to develop. So what happens is say, you know, we have all these little bacterias and the antibiotics come in and they get rid of the bacteria. But there are always gonna be a few that don't get killed. You know, they don't kill 100%. There might be one or two or a few little bacteria cells that survive because they're super strong and they can resist the antibiotic. Well, when we're using these antibiotics all the time, we're killing off all the weak bacteria, but all of those strong bacteria are sticking around and they reproduce and they grow and their populations grow until we get to a point where our antibiotics don't work anymore because now we just have all these bacteria that are totally resistant to them. And that is a big problem. If you have these bacterial infections now that we can't treat with antibiotics, it's going to be a big issue for human health. And we're already seeing this happen. In hospitals, there are cases of people getting these bacterial infections that can't be treated with antibiotics. C. diff is one that is very common in hospitals, and we don't want to see more of this thing going on. So a great way to help with that problem is to stop feeding antibiotics to our animals. So this is an awesome thing, I think, but there are some caveats. So it's just human antibiotics that they're getting rid of. So it's not that their chickens will never get antibiotics. They just won't get human antibiotics. So that's a thing. And also, they're not getting rid of the routine use of antibiotics. So right now, the way it stands is it's not like, oh, a chicken got sick and we gave it some medicine. They are feeding these animals antibiotics in the feed constantly to prevent them from getting sick, which also has a side effect of helping them grow faster. So it's still an issue. It's still something we have to work on, but this is definitely a big step in the right direction. And another thing is that while this change is exciting, it doesn't speak to the conditions that these animals are living in. Because one of the reasons that these antibiotics are being used so much is because the chickens, they are just like sitting ducks out there, or sitting chickens? I don't know. They're in these conditions that are so terrible, like they're just basically waiting to get sick because of the conditions that they are living in. And this doesn't even do anything to work on that and help get them better conditions, which is super important, not just from an animal welfare perspective, but also for our health. You know, healthier animals means healthier food for us, and it also means a stronger food system. We want our chickens to be healthy and strong and not weak and sick, because that's going to help make sure that the food system is resilient and can withstand when things happen. You know, we want these chickens to be able to survive and not be so susceptible to any little thing that comes along. So ultimately, I'm not going to tell you to go get a chicken sandwich from McDonald's. You know, it's not at the point there where I would eat at McDonald's. I definitely would not eat their chicken, and getting chicken from your local farmers who are doing things the right way, raising their animals in a healthy environment, is always going to be your best option. But with that said, this is exciting because McDonald's is such a huge purchaser of chicken. You know, they are a huge company. They buy so much chicken, and when someone like them makes this decision, it really impacts the supply chain. So when McDonald's says, hey, we're not going to buy chickens that are fed human antibiotics anymore, things are going to start to shift because they are buying a lot of the chicken that's produced in this country. And so it is something that can help, you know, move the needle a little bit and get things going. And I think this really speaks to the power of the consumer, because they're doing this because they want people to feel good about eating their food. And while I still wouldn't feel great about eating their food, it's showing that they're listening to what people are saying, and that when you voice your opinion and say, this is important to me, healthy, integrity food is important to me, that these companies are going to start listening, because for them, it's either go with what the public wants and stay in business, or it's potentially going out of business if people don't want to buy their products anymore. So definitely keep doing what you're doing to support local food, to support organics, to support food that is raised the right way, because as we can see here, it is making a difference and it can really make big changes. And I also have a couple recipes to share with you this week. So the first one is from backtoherroots.com. It is her honey ginger lemonade health tonic, and this looks like a great option for when you are sick. Now, I'm a big proponent of drinking like tea with lemon and honey in it to help you get better and just feel better when you're sick, because it can really help with your throat and just kind of make you at least feel a little bit better when you're feeling really crummy. But this is actually another option if you're not a tea drinker or if you don't like hot beverages. So her drink has honey, lemon, ginger, basically all the things in the name, but she actually serves it cold. And I thought that was really interesting. So for those of you who don't like hot tea or don't like hot drinks when you're sick, this is a cold option. You can drink this one warm as well, so it kind of works for both of those. Or if you don't like tea or whatever, this is gonna be a great one to try. And I think it's definitely something that I will try the next time I am sick. Now, I don't know whether I'll drink it hot or cold, because I do tend to like that really hot liquid, like scalding my throat. It makes me feel like I don't know, it's doing something in there and it really soothes my throat. But if you get sick in the summer, I think maybe having a cold beverage would be nice, and it's also gonna help you get those fluids in that you need when you're sick. So check out that recipe, pin it or whatever, save it for the next time you get sick, because that one is going to be a great one. Also, I have another recipe for you. This one is from 100 Days of Real Food, and it is a soup recipe. And I've been like pinning and talking about lots of soups lately, but I mean, it's winter and you want soup, right? So this is her kale sausage and white bean soup. And I really like this one because I don't usually think of sausage as something to put in my soups. I don't know why. I mean, I use it, you know, it may be like a gumbo or something like that, but it's just not something that comes to mind for me when I think about, oh, what could I put in my soup? So I thought that was a cool thing about this recipe, and it's just another great option to have to get us through these cold winter months, even though spring is just around the corner for those of us in the Northern Hemisphere, which I am so excited about. I cannot wait for spring. So that's it for this week's Real Food Roundup. I hope you liked it, and make sure to leave me some comments below. I want to know what you think about this whole McDonald's thing and the antibiotics and all of that. I would love to hear your thoughts on that, because I think it's pretty big news. And if you are new to my channel and you want more real food tips and tricks, then make sure that you subscribe, because eating a real foods diet is so important for your health and also for just having a full, vibrant life. But it's not always easy, especially when you're just starting out. But at the same time, I know that if you have all of the information and recipes and resources and all of that stuff that you need, that you can definitely make it happen. And that's why I make these videos, because I want to make living a real foods lifestyle as easy for you as possible. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of your real foods journey. I hope you're having a great day, and I'll talk to you next time.